Hi everyone, today we would like to show you how to do a polyethylene insole with a new concept, which is the opacity factory. What is the opacity factory? It's a system where you can scan the foot, scan vacuum silicon bags or scan a foam box with an iPad and a sensor 3D. So we're going to show you the demo, and after that of course you can contact us directly if you have any questions. So let's. So Thomas is with me today. Thomas, maybe you can
present yourself. Hi everyone. Yeah, I'm Thomas. I have my own cabinet in the medical house in France, and I work with SIDA since almost 10 years now. And I participate to the development of the system, and now I use the system every day. So I'm gonna explain how it works basically.
Let's go.
Yeah, so basically to understand the concept, you have two applications on the iPad, and you can work from A to Z on the iPad. So you do the scanning process, and you will be able to take the order from the iPad, or you can take the scan and then take the order from the computer. So you have two ways of working. So
maybe we can show the four applications that you need on the iPad.
Basically on the iPad you have the Podatech application, so you will be able to take an order from the Podatech application. You have the voxel scan, in fact it's basically the scan application, and you have for the at the beginning, just for the first use, you have the calibrator and the structure sensor, so at the first use of the iPad. So basically you work only with the two first one.
Okay, so super easy. So next step, Thomas, we're gonna scan a vacuum silicone bags
with basically the process for with your patient, it's basically the same. So you do the clinical examination, you do everything, and then instead of making your insoles by yourself, you take the mold. So you have multiple options. First, you take the mold with the vacuum bags. We advise this option. Why? Because you can take a mold in a corrective position. So you can already take like the vacuum bag here. You have the medial arch correction, for example. So you will save time online. Or you can use also a crash box like this. Or you can use also and take the scan of the feet barefoot.
Yes,
barefoot
straight feet. On the feet.
Yeah, so you have multiple options. You can even scan some insoles from last year, orthotics from last year, for example, stuff like this, or from last month, for example, you made an insole in your cabinet, it worked really well, the patient wants a second one, you don't have the scan, you can scan the previous insole. So this is really nice. Basically, you can do whatever you want. So, just to understand well, you have two way of working. If you have a really fast connection, you can use you can do everything from the Podiatech application. If you go on the club, if you go to hospital, if you have not a really nice connection in the cabinet, like me for example, I have not really fast connection, you can start with the voxel scan because you have an offline version. So you can basically take the scan. It will be saved inside the iPad, and then when you have a better connection, a bit later, the next day, you can upload the scan in the Podatech application. So we advise to do this way because you have no mistake available, because everything will be saved inside the iPad, so no big problems in that way.
Okay.
It's less risky, let's say. So I will show how it works.
So let's go for a voxel scan.
So you click on voxel scan, basically. You have for the first time when you will use, of course, you go to settings and you put your
So maybe I can explain that. Before to start, what you need to have from us, it's an ID and a password, okay? When you go to the settings of the voxel scan, you need to put sidas.voxelcare.com, your ID, your password, okay? Then you connect, we can do a test here, boom, successfully connected. This means that Voxel Scan and Podiatech are able to discuss together, let's say. The data will be exchanged easily. So now let's go to order an insoles. So reference,
Let's do... as an obligation, you have to put reference the first name. That's it. So reference, we advise to put the localization of the place you saw the patient, for example, or your name, or you put whatever you want.
So, it's up to you.
So for example, I can put test one.
The things you are filling into this will be downloaded into the Podiatric app, okay? So you will not have to do double work. The name and the ID and all that will be sent onto Podiatric. So no worries. So then we choose always, we do the left, then the right, so L plus R. Then we choose phone box, which is actually phone box is this one, the pink one, okay? But it is the same for the blue bags. You choose phone box also, okay? So either you do phone box or you do vacuum silicone bags. You click on phone box onto this, and then how is oriented the foot? Is it the toes down or the toes up? Huh? So it's super intuitive, it's super easy. Let's go for next, Thomas.
Yeah, so you click on next and then you will have basically to scan your vacuum bags.
Yeah.
So you start on the left foot.
Left
so
foot. Foot always
will be on the right hand.
Always the left first. Huh?
Okay, what you have to do basically is to, when you click on a scan, you have to have all the vacuum bags in white color. If you have blue color somewhere, you will have a hole in your data. So it's pretty fast. You click, when everything is white, you click on stop.
Perfect. So we have the left. It's taking a few seconds. Huh? It's the file is around 10 megabyte per foot, if I'm not mistaken. So this, okay, perfect.
Okay, you control that we have no holes in the data.
Yeah, so we can see it's
so full. So you can click on next. Okay. As you can see, it's pretty fast. And I do the same things to the right foot. Okay, then everything is white. As so you usually, can see, it's really fast. Huh?
So usually, the best way to go is you show the sensor, you show it, you show the arch, then you show the heel. It's the most important part of the orthotics. Then when you have this, you click on save. Okay, so once this is done, your patient can leave the cabinet,
yeah.
Okay? Because the data are into the software, and you can download them anytime you like on the OPST Factory app.
Yep. So I'm gonna show you how it works. Basically, you go back to the Voxel Scan application. You go to order this time, and you see we have test one from today. You have the date of the day and the timetable. Okay, so to be sure it was the good patient. So you just click on it. Then you have 3D data. You click on the 3D data and you have the left and the right foot. So you just have to click on it and it will be uploaded to the Podiatric application automatically. Okay, and you click on upload. Of course, when you want to upload the data, you have to be connected to the internet at that step.
Let's go.
Upload. Successfully upload. And I do the same for the other foot. Upload. Okay.
Okay.
Pretty simple.
This way of taking the scan is super easy because you don't need internet. It means that you can do your 5 patients during the day, okay? And maybe at the end of the day, you just click on download, okay, 5 times, and then at the in evening or next day, you can do it from internet with your browser. Okay, so with you just go on the website we have behind us, and you can do you can put your correction, choose the insoles, and send us the order. So that's why we show you the offline, because it's easier, let's say. Okay,
let's say it's safer, because when you have a small connection problem, you can have some bugs and stuff like this. So with offline version, you never have bugs because it's not linked to the data. So okay, let's do it. So just for you to understand well, you have two options at this step when you download it and the data inside the cloud. Let's say you can finish the order from the iPad. So if you have time, if you are in your cabinet, you want to finish everything from the iPad, show to the patient, you can do it from the iPad, or you can do it from your laptop. So you open, doesn't matter which laptop you have, you open on a browser and you connect yourself to your account. So we are going to do this. So this is the main page of your Podiatech website. So you have, when you are connected, you have three main pages. So you have the patient list, you have the order list, and you have the batches. What is it? It's the list of your all your patients, the list of the order created by your patient, because you can have some patient but no order with this patient, okay? And batches, what is it? It's the follow-up. Basically, when you did an order, you want to control if it's already made, is it sent or not, or the follow-up, let's say. So when I uploaded my data inside the software, basically I have to go to the order, and then I have this patient, not a patient yet, it's because I didn't upload the data. So Winter test number one, it's the one we just did it.
So it was sent on the cloud, and now it's on the app, and you can just start to do your install.
Yeah, basically when it's in the cloud, nothing can happen because it's inside the cloud. It's also inside the iPad, so it's saved everywhere, let's say. So when I open this order,
so we click on modify,
open, and then the first step, automatically, you have nothing to press, he will ask to control the data, what you just scanned before. Okay, so this step is an important step, but simple step. Let's say it's basically to control the data you just scanned before. So you just have, you see on the screen here, you have a gray, let's say a gray foot, and the green is the data you just scanned. You just have to put one on the second one, just to control if it's well aligned. So you can see that the gray, the green, it's outside the gray. So just you have to put like this. Just nice alignment. It's really simple step, but important still. Okay. Nice alignment. In here it's okay.
Perfect.
You just have to make an alignment between the gray and the green. That's it. Then you click on OK.
So this was the left first, right?
Yeah. Always the left and then the right. Okay, and the same thing to the right foot. Okay, as you can see, I have to go down a little bit. And here, be sure I have a great alignment. Okay, and okay. As you can see, it's really fast.
Quick and easy.
To give you an idea, I control with my watch at the cabinet. It take approximately, like, let's say 2 minutes between scan and do all the steps. So it's really fast. I mean the scanning and upload the scan in the software. After these few small steps, you have the data online. That's it. You just, as you can see on the screen, and then it's always better if you can just move the three little point here on the screen. I mean, you put to the first metatarsal head, five metatarsal head, and the center of the heel. It's to be sure that the data will be nice in a nice position, not like this or like that.
Yeah, and
it's really fast.
And
step.
Thomas, it is the deepest point, right?
Yeah, in fact, the three deepest point of the foot, and in general, it's always the first, the five, and the center of the heel.
Okay.
So as you can see, it takes 5 seconds, and then you click on OK, and you save the data inside the cloud.
Also, a small trick for this point, what you can do is you can put stickers or marks straight on the bags, okay? And it means when you will have the scan on the screen, you can see onto the blue bags, you will see your stickers. So this will make your life easier by positioning the point.
So the next step, now you're sure you have the 3D data inside the software, so you can you can be more precise about the name, last name, and so on. just to be sure in English. Yeah. So now you can order your in-source basically. So you go always, you start from the left and you go to the right. It's really easy to understand the software, easy to okay. understand. So you go to product and then you will have three way to personalize your in-source. It's really simple to understand. You have basically the pro level, advanced level and elite level. What does that mean? If you have only a patient with not a lot of deviation, not a lot of problems, and you just want to take a mold, more than in-source, and you don't need to add some correction. So you just use level pro, you will have to select an OPCT, that means an in-source, a base of the in-source. And we are going in CIDAS to mold the in-source following your data and send the in-source like this. So we don't talk about correction in plus. If you select advanced level, what does that mean? You select the OPCT and then you're gonna choose some different correction on your in-source, on the list. I will show you how it works, and then we will receive the order with your special list, with the special correction you want for your patient, and we're gonna make the in-source with the correction you asked. The level elite, it's way more complex for you because you will have to select the all the different correction, but you are going to place the different correction by yourself. So you have the 3D screen and you are gonna place the correction, personalize the correction a bit deeper. So it's longer to use as a consumer, but you can be a bit more precise. Basically, we advise to use the advanced version. Why? Because you're gonna save a lot of time in your cabinet, and it's not a big difference between the two prices. So if you go to a level advanced, I will show you how it works.
It's important to re-understand. A pro level, it's only a cast. Basically, we print the cast and we mold the insoles onto it. Advanced, you choose the correction, we positionate them onto the insoles, the cast, whatever. Elite, you do everything by yourself. Correction, positionating. So it's really technical. So today we stay on advanced. It's the quickest to show.
Yeah. Okay. So it doesn't matter which level you selected, you have the same beginning. So you can choose if you want the volume shoe. What does that mean? If you don't know really well the OPCT concept with all the different in-source, it will make your life a bit easier. What does that mean? If you select some level, sports shoes, the software will advise you some OPCT from the range dedicated to the sports shoes. So it's a bit easier if you don't know really well the OPCT range. Then when you select your volume shoe, you start basically as usual, you start on the left, you move to the right. So you go to OPCT and then you have all the OPCT list.
All the range, so for this, you go on the catalog or you ask your local sales guy advice on which one to choose. So let's choose one.
Yeah. You can choose one like Laurent explained, or of course you can select two different pairs. If you click on it one time, you have all the detail of the OPCT run, for example. You have all the materials put inside the modules. And of course, if you have, for example, one commercial guy, he have city shoes all day long and he do running during lunchtime. Of course, it's always better if you make two pairs, one for the city shoes, one for the running shoes, because it's not the same volume. You can use, for example, extra slim city for the city shoes, so it's way slimmer and not the same materials. And then when you select your different OPCT, then you can go to the right and you go to options. So basically, when you selected your different option, I mean, if you want a positive cast, if you want 100% finished insoles or not, if you want top cover separated or attached, then if you selected before the level pro, basically your job is finished. So you selected the OPCT, you selected the option for the finishing of the insoles, and then you take the order. And a few days after, you will receive the insoles. if you selected advanced version, advanced level, you will have to put some correction. So basically we decided to separate the different correction in four different categories. What does that mean? When you talk about one correction on one in-source, if I want, for example, a metatarsal bar, basically it's not that easy because you can place metatarsal bar between layers, you can place inside the positive cast, you can place the metatarsal bar behind, you can place a resin correction. So we decided to make these four different categories. So you have the category positive cast correction. What does that mean? So all the correction will be milled inside the positive cast. And basically the in-source will be molded on the positive cast, on the corrected positive cast.
Important to say, all the casting correction are free, okay? So you can order 10 correction if you like into the positive, it's free because for us it's just a machine that will produce them.
So that's why you have a really big list of the correction on the positive cast correction, yeah. Because you have no limit, you have only the block. The block is 4 centimeters, so you can do whatever you want inside the block. So if you want to put, for example, a metatarsal bar, you click on metatarsal bar, and by default it will be 3 millimeters metatarsal bar, and you can change, you can put 7 millimeter, you can put 2 millimeter, you can personalize the measure of the correction. When you selected the positive cast correction, then you move to one step, and you have in red here all the correction will be between layers, I mean under the top cover. So you have a list a bit shorter, of course, because it will be materials add inside the in-source. So you can have element under the first metatarsal bones, you have metatarsal bar, you have a dome, you have some technical elements, yeah, under the metatarsal bones. You have
the library is pretty, yeah, wide, so yeah, then you can play with it.
Yeah, and on every correction you can select between different materials. So if you move one step, you will have all the resin refinement. What does that mean? You have, when you have in-source, for example, this one is opacity 1, you have already a resin refinement on the in-source, but you can change the refinement or add a new refinement in resins. So you can personalize the in-source, your tortoise. So when you click on the resin refinement, you have also another list, as you can see on the screen, and you can change the refinement or add a new one.
So same, huh? It's a wide library. With this, you can play with it.
Yes.
And then, so Thomas,
and then
the last step.
Bottom correction, the last step. If you is not enough, that means you did some correction inside the cast. You did some correction between layers. You change the resin refinement, so it's already really nice. Then you can also add some piece of materials at the bottom of the in-source. Okay, for example, your medial arch like this. So you have the list, and you select inside the list. You have a quite wide list also, and you select the correction for the medial arch here, for example.
I just want to explain something. Do not think that you have to go through every step. You can just choose your opacity, go to the resin reinforcement if you like, and then finish. You don't have to go at all these steps, to go through all these steps. You can go straight to the end. Actually, now we're going to confirm the order. Thomas, up. So you confirm the order, and then the order is into your basket. It's basically like Amazon or whatever. Your basket, you are free to confirm your basket when you want. Just be sure that, just keep in mind that every basket confirmed is one box. So if you order every time insoles per insoles, you will receive box per box. So if you want to have 5 pairs shipped at the same time, just order them together.
Yeah, and just to add something important, you have a lot of control steps, so it's not easy to make a mistake. What does that mean? You have, before to send the order, you have few different steps. So he will show you the summary, so with the opacity you selected, the resume of the different correction you added to your in-source, and then you validate. So it's it's going to the baskets, like Laurent explained. And then you have to validate the basket. So you have a few different steps to control the order, not to make any mistakes. And then when you have between three and five different orders, different insoles, you validate the baskets, and then you follow up your order. And you receive the last product. The product at the end will be nice finishing like this, okay, with all the creations you added inside. And like Laurent explained, we advise to, if you want comfortable insoles, not to put too many creations at the same time. So if you add some creation between layers, maybe you don't need behind, or you have the choice.